Hello, in this video, we are in the topic of force vibration and we are going to learn about the concept of resonance, magnification factor, and the effect of damping. Mainly, I'm going to use this particular app by PHET titled Resonance. You may access it via Google, try to Google it with the correct keyword. And in this app, we are going to see a driver here or a shaker, which shakes this system consisting of a mass, a spring, and also a damper. And via this app, we can infer that the equivalent model is that of a damp force vibration consisting of a mass and a damper and a spring, and with best excitation. So the best excitation is the concept of base excitation is that the base instead of the mass is being oscillated. So the driving force is given to the base, which makes eventually the mass to oscillate. You can try to find more explanation about this base excitation via the textbook of dynamics by Merriam-Crich, chapter 8. And to cut it short, we can derive the equation of motion in this form. This is the equation of motion for the base excitation. And from here, we can see some of the terms. So notice that there are two different frequencies. So first is the natural frequency of the system. So in the app, we can control the value of the natural frequency by setting the value of the mass as well as the spring constant. So in this app, it is given that the default natural frequency is 1 Hz. And the next term is this term coming from the damping. So the setting of the C, the damping constant or the damping coefficient. And the C and zeta is related via this equation. And secondly, the driver or the shaker, it also has the frequency, the driving frequency. We can set the value of it as well as the amplitude. So it is given here that the driving frequency is of the form of B sine omega t. And this is the term of the driving frequency actually. Let me bring again this equation of motion concerning the base excitation of the system. And for the simplicity of our discussion, let us first consider the undamped case. So in which C is set as zero. So that means this term will be gone. And it will be reduced to this simpler equation. From this simpler equation, we can derive this equation of magnification factor, M, which is capital X divided by B, is given as this equation. So from this equation, we can plot the graph of magnification factor relating this M as well as the ratio of omega and omega n. So, and we are getting this graph of M and omega over omega n, which says the relation between how much magnification factor we get when we try to vary the ratio of omega and omega n. This graph in the concept of vibration or the theory of vibration is very important because this will let us understand how much the amplitude of the response will be magnified. So to explain it and to give it an example, what this says is this capital X and B, we can think of them as input and output. This B is our input, which is the amplitude of the driving force. And whereas this capital X is the amplitude of the response, we can think of it as our output. So now, let's say that our B is set as 1 centimeter. So 1 centimeter, and our magnification factor is 5. So from here, from this equation, we can conclude or estimate that the amplitude of our response, or probably you can think of it as the output, will be 5 centimeter. By setting 1 centimeter of input, you are gonna get the response of the mass to be 5 centimeter. To appreciate this graph of magnification factor further, let us consider 3 different cases of omega. So the frequency of the harmonic forcing function. So the first case is when we set the omega to be very large as compared to our omega n. Remember that our omega n is initially set as 1 hertz. So let us consider the value of omega, which is very large, maybe 1000 or 1 million. So here, omega over omega n will be very large. And you can think of it in the concept of limit in mathematics. So this term will approach infinity. So 1 minus infinity will approach minus infinity. And your 1 here divided by minus infinity finally will give the value of m to approach 0. So it is expressed here. The first zone, or the first case, is in which your omega is very large, your value of m will approach 0. Now, second, let's think about the case when your omega is very small. Say your omega is 0.01 or something. So this means that your omega, your driving frequency, is 100 times smaller than your natural frequency. So this term here will approach 0. 1 minus 0 will be 1, and then 1 minus 1 divided by 1 will be 1. So your m, the value of m, will approach 1 here, this zone, in the case when your omega is very small as compared to your omega n, the natural frequency of the system. And finally, this is when the resonance occurs. So when your omega is the same as omega n, so you're gonna set your omega to be 1 as well. So this will give me 1 divided by 1, which is 1. 1 minus 1 will be 0, and 1 divided by 0 will be infinity. So your value of m will approach infinity, and this will give us resonance. Let us now play around with the real app. This is the mass with the spring, the system, and then this is the driver. You can always do the free vibration, give the external excitation, and see that the mass is oscillating. But that's not what we are interested here. We are interested in force vibration. So let me reset all. The ruler is set on so that we can see clearly. And the damping constant, I'm going to try to set it as small as possible. And this app will allow us to set 0.05 as the minimum value. Gravity is turned off. The natural frequency of the system is set as 1 hertz. And the amplitude of the driver, to let us see the oscillation of the driver, I'm gonna set it at 1 centimeter. Now let us try to validate the 3 cases we had discussed just now, the 3 cases of different value of omega. So the first case is that with a very large frequency, the driving frequency. Let us set at the maximum value that allows us. So here we can set it at 6 hertz, which means 6 times of the natural frequency of the system. Since the amplitude of the driver is 1 centimeter, we are expecting the driver to oscillate at this line of 1 centimeter. And by the theory, for large value of frequency, the mass will oscillate with magnification factor of 0, meaning the mass will be stationary. So let's see what happens when I hit the driver on. So we can confirm here, though the driver is oscillating with 1 centimeter amplitude, the output, which is the response of the mass, we can see clearly that it stays there. Moving on to the second case, what happens now if we set the driving frequency to be very small? So in this case, let us set at 0.1, meaning 10 times smaller than the natural frequency. So according to the theory, the magnification factor will approach 1. So we are expecting with the driving amplitude to be 1 centimeter, the response of the mass will be 1 centimeter as well. We're expecting the mass to move somewhere here, oscillating to this line. So let's see. So we can also confirm the second case to be true according to the theory. So the mass, the response of the mass is around 1 centimeter. Finally, let's check the case when the driving frequency is 1, which is exactly the same to the natural frequency. We are expecting that the resonance will occur, and let's see what happens. We can confirm here that it goes wild, the oscillation, and then the amplitude of the oscillation, the amplitude of the response of the system, it goes through the roof. So essentially, theoretically, it goes to infinity, but because there is a damping constant applied here, so it is not really infinity, but to a limited number. But you can get the concept here. Oh, and we can also check the effect of damping. What happens if we increase the value of damping? Of course, we are going to expect that the vibration, the oscillation will lessen, and you know, finally it will come to a stop. The effect of damping is also illustrated by the equation of magnification factor with the addition of damping. So when we consider the damped case in which C is not zero, we come back to this original equation of motion, and from which we can derive this equation. Although this looks complicated, what is most important here is the graph. The graph resulting from this equation of magnification factor, and we can see here that it is being overlapped with various variations of zeta value. This is the case when zeta is 0 and up until the case when zeta is 1. So you can clearly see that there is a flattening of the curve, flattening of the graph as the value of the damping increases. So from this talk, finally, with this understanding of magnification ratio, magnification factor, you can at least try to understand the design mindset in a vibration system in order to lessen the response of the system. There are at least two different ways. Either you can try to increase the damping, you can think about damping, try to redesign your system, or you can work out the ratio of omega and omega n. Either you can try to change the value of omega if it is possible, or the value of omega n if it is also allowable, to to let you bring your ratio of omega or omega n further from 1 to the left or to the right. Thank you.